All right, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to some more DayZ. My name is Raven from the Sky. Let's... Oh, that'll work. This'll work. Ooh, I need this so bad. First things first, we're gonna fix the pants. Duct tape. I forgot. I'm talking about a sewing kit. I forgot all about duct tape work, too. I know they kind of... Oh, it won't work against... won't work for the boots, though. Won't work for this, either. But it'll work for the bag. Makes sense. Patch holes. You put duct tape over the holes in the bag. Nothing a little duct tape can't fix. Unfortunately, it won't. You can't fix nothing else. You used to cut... Uh-oh, whoops. I almost taped the... You used to could fix everything. But of course, they nerfed that. Alright, I'll keep the duct tape. I can't even fix... Dang, I can't fix the holster. The chest holster. I'll keep the duct tape, though. In case the pants or something get ruined. You just could fix everything, man. That sucks. Alright. Oh. Yep. This takes up more space, though. Four extra slots. I mean, it's just four extra slots, which I have the space for. Want the Vega, but I don't know. I might drop the shotgun if I find a Vega. I'm thinking about it now. I might drop the shotty and just keep the AK-74U, aka the baby Draco. Is it the baby or the mini? I don't think this is the mini though. I was gonna, cause there is a such thing as a mini, but I get them confused. Gas is still on that. Gas is forever on that area now. I don't know, one day I need to do that, just deck myself out in full hazmat and explore some of that loot. That's where the best loot is now, those gas zones. But I feel like any all military zones, and some towns even, can be classified as a gas zone. Or, I mean, I'm saying that they not can be it, they are. It's just a matter of when and, you know, where the gas is going to drop. And then the loot, the good loot is gonna spawn there. Alright, so far the coast is clear. But you can't, you're not gonna be able to make it without a, without hazmat, unfortunately. So, you need hazmat. If you don't have hazmat, then your character's just gonna bleed to death. And currently there's no cure, at least I haven't found one. I think I may have heard something about a blood... You can do a blood transfusion. It makes sense, because... I mean, you would be taking out the poisonous blood and then inserting clean in. So it makes sense. Although I have not tested that theory, so take it with a grain of salt. And I have not seen that theory tested. So take it with a grain of salt. Now, if you see it, if I do it in this video, obviously it would work. At least at the time of the recording. I always want to say it's the time of the recording because you never know. This is a summer series. Between now and when I record in the summer, they might drop a patch. And they might patch that. You know? They patch, you know, things get patched. We all know that. Things get nerfed, buffed. It is what it is. And you just have to roll with the punches. I mean, it doesn't really change my love for the game. Yeah, it may suck some things. End up getting pushed to being rare to find, hard to find, which otherwise were, I guess, uncommon. As if it wasn't already hard enough to find enough with everybody hoarding things and burying things. They want to make it even harder, which I guess it adds more so to the survival aspect, not making things too easy. Because that, to me, that increases the mundaneness. Yep. How is it easy? Well, here's what, if everything's handed to you, you know, you're going to just not really appreciate it. And you're just going to whatever. You're going to treat it like whatever, and you're going to get bored with it in the mundane. But I feel like you appreciate it more when you grind out, when you finally, you're looking for this, right? But a player has it, and you win the gunfight, and you, I mean, it's more appreciative that way. It didn't come to you easy, even though you may feel that way if you're like a veteran, man. That was easy getting over a noob. Okay, but fact of the matter is, you still had to work to get it. Well, you had to really walk around the map, and the third military base, you finally find it after playing for like hours, you know, something like that. That's why they have it that way. Versus, oh, here you go. Soon you spawn. Oh, look, there's a baby Drake right at your feet. Here you go. Or it's already in your inventory. Happy surviving. And here's your trusty survival knife. Swiss Army knife. Don't leave home without it. Happy surviving. It's like, no. Here. You have rags. No, or not even that. You have like bandage and some fruit and a glow stick. Survive. That's your starter pack. Piece of fruit, a glow stick, and a bandage. And you dropped in like this. And you just have to kind of wing it, unless, like I said, but with the YouTube and everything, you're good to go. Heck, if you're watching me on YouTube right now, you're good to go. Learn how to make a feed. You can learn the absolute basics and then set off on your own. You'll be fine. So with that being said, definitely give this game a shot, all right? Promise me. I promise you, you'll enjoy it. And hey, if you don't, that's okay. No judgment, judgment free. You know, it's not everybody's cup of tea. Simulations is not everybody's cup of tea. They prefer arcadey, fast twitch, zerg, zerg, zergity, zerg games. And that's cool. Cakewalk, easy mode. That's cool. Nothing wrong with easy mode. I play my YouTube series story mode, because I don't feel like being stuck at the level 99 boss over difficulty level that you're not going to get really rewarded other than a trophy for. Unless, I know that some games have New Game Plus, and Dragon's Dogma has that, which I'm thinking I might go back through and I might film episodes of missions I didn't do. I finally beat it at the time of the recording. By the time this goes up, it should be right around, actually, by this goes up, it'll probably be like a month since I've completed it. But at the time of this recording, I just completed it. So yeah. But it has it's a lot more to it than just a beeline story. By the time I decided to just finish it, I was so far into the story. Originally going in, I said I was going to probably do some side quests and not skip them. I feel like when you skip side quests, you kind of miss out on an integral, like 50% of what makes the game what it is. Not trying to make you feel guilty or talk crap about people who skip side quests. I understand. Because, I'm, especially when you're a content creator, I'm neck deep in series. It's like, let's get to the point where you don't really have time to sit and just, oh my God, here we go. Spend hundreds of hours on side quests, or hundreds of hours just free roaming. Ah! Sit your butt down. The perks of having a lightweight build. Power shots. Knocked him down in two hits with a pickaxe, which is arguably the best melee weapon in the game. But that's as per like 3 years ago. I haven't looked at any like comparison videos since then. Since like 2020. A lot of stuff has been nerfed and buffed and patched since then. So I guess I should do my research before I make a bold claim like that, huh? But yeah, you're missing out on Integral 50%. I said you don't really have time to, you know, sit and just free roam. But yet I'm doing that right now with this, walking around for hours at a time. You can hear them random sounds. Go through the woods and then we'll cut through here. This town is full of zombies. You don't have time for a side quest, but you have time to like spend hours making DayZ. Yep. You got it. Gee golly gah. The way of the world, huh? Wow, Raven hypocrite much? Ha! But no, really, it's just how it is. But I sort of do have the time at least, because I mass record and try to stay ahead of the game, ahead on recording. That way I have the time to kind of sit and relax. Like, you ever sit and relax and play a game and really get immersed in it and enjoy it without having to worry about recording? Is the video glitched up? Is it didn't, you know, is the software still working? Because if that messes up, you lose your whole footage. And that's the worst thing in the world, man. To lose all the footage. It's one thing to lose a portion where you can just stop the video and then start from there. Do a bit of chop editing, cut out all the distorted parts or whatever. To lose the whole thing and start all over again. Either replay back up to that point or do what I do and say screw it and just keep going. It's something, man. But the show must go on. Sometimes there's a convoy, a destroyed convoy up here. A military loot up here too, but I don't see it. I feel like you'd see zombies like kind of like roaming around by now. And I don't see any of those. I don't see any zombies. I don't see any Humvees, anything. Forgot to refill I'm so busy running my mouth. What did I forget to do? Fill the darn water bottle up. Luckily there's a fountain where we're going. I'll be good on water until I get there. Not in the red. And even if I was, I could just eat like a pumpkin or a pepper or something. And get that water up. Don't get me wrong, like I said before, fruits and vegetables give you a double whammy, hunger and thirst, but water will always be the best option as far as thirst goes. The fruits and vegetables mainly for like the situation I'm in where you're in between towns and your bar is red, you know, stuff like that. Your character's dehydrated, making that noise. That wasn't there before, making that weird noise, that, you know, when they're dehydrated. I just noticed it, this year. I mean, seemingly always adding in little things that you may miss or not pay no attention to until to the fact that you can't not pay attention. The heck was that? How could you miss it? Yep. I remember I got into that gunfight with that car full of people. I ran straight up this hill. They stopped right around, like, right here. They tried to run me off the road, run over me. They ran me off the road. I went in the car, run me off the road. I'm not in the car, but I was walking that double barrel. I heard him. I said, screw that. They stopped, like, right over. I said, screw that. Good thing I had a lightweight build, man. Because I ran full speed all the way up that hill. They tried to hit me, but couldn't. See, that's what I'm talking about. Benefits, I feel like, as for now, never say never, but as for now, I'm probably never going to go back. I love to lightweight build, maybe moderate at the heaviest. When my stamina be like at half or fall just below it, but for the most part, try to have more than half stamina if you're going to run this build. Try to have like a submachine gun or a shotgun, or just a shotgun, just a, whatever you, or a pistol. I do recommend pistols. I mean, like I said, a bad firefight, and you've exhausted everything, you still got your pistol, pull it out, you know, in the fight. I just see I got all powerhouses. Like the powerhouse of the assault rifles is the AK. As far as I know, it's so many different rifles out now, it's just ridiculous. But I'm going with the AK as a powerhouse, especially in this game. I don't know, correct me in the comment section, what do you guys, the LAR what? I'm going with this here. Everything, stopping power, the Deagle, the shotgun, Baby Draco, and everything I have, you know, has stopping power. Push does come to shove. Always does. And when it does, I'll be ready for it. He's going to have a surprise waiting on him. That Baby Draco. I don't have the visor on, so there's really no need for me to stop in there. I feel like. So I'm gonna keep it moving. When you hear something like that, it sounds like that sound when someone rushes through the bushes. Like it'll make an ambient sound like that. Like a regular noise, like you hear that tree. And make you turn around thinking somebody there, and it's not. I mean, every time is almost like that with me. I gotta get used to just, man, that's just the random sounds Daisy makes. And it seemed like the moment you get used to it, the moment you say, okay, that's just a random sound Daisy makes. Oh, it's not a random sound this time. You know, you drop your guard. Just that rotten luck, won't it? That's why you should never really drop your guard. I'm looking around now. So far, so good. I don't see anything. Anyone. Usually this town be kind of full too, full of zombies. So I'm gonna down this. We didn't really have anything to drink when we ate that breakfast. Or that dinner of champions of peppers and olives and onions. Peppers and pumpkin. The last video. Character's probably dehydrated. Digest all that food. Right. Ideally, you want to drink until you're full. There we go. I want to fill this back up. Come on, come on, come on. Look at that stupid headlamp. I'll never use that. It's always something you don't use. Isn't it? Always something you don't use. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to stop it here for today. Thanks for watching. My name is Raven from the Sky. If you enjoyed the episode, drop a like and subscribe to the channel and see if it's grow. Take care, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Peace.